Good morning. One man has died and two people are in hospital after a unit fire in Brisbane's north early this morning. Meg Sides is at the scene in Clayfield. Meg, good morning. It was a complicated and understandably terrifying evacuation for those residents.
It absolutely was. The emergency services were called here to the scene just before five this morning. The population in this apartment block is predominantly elderly residents, so it's been quite a difficult operation to get a lot of those people out, particularly because while we understand the fire started in one of the units here, it spread to the elevator. So getting people out this morning was incredibly difficult. And of course, now we know that a 55-year-old man has passed away this morning. Many have been treated at the scene, more than a dozen for smoke inhalation, with a few more taken to hospital. We spoke to some residents and their neighbours this morning as they were coming out to see what was happening.
We know a few of the people in the building and it's a bit scary for them, especially as they would have had trouble getting in and out too. So it's a bit frightening, really.
When I was woken up, I thought that I was on a movie set. And then there were people from aliens from out of space over my bed waking me up because I sleep pretty heavily. They said, quickly, come on, we want you to get out of the building. And I said, well, what for? Why? And then they told me that there was smoke.
Police remain on the scene this morning and an investigation is now underway to try and find the cause of this blaze. Sophie.
Okay, Meg, thank you. Serbian star Novak Djokovic has reclaimed the title of Australian Open champion, what was one of the most emotional Grand Slam wins seen at Melbourne Park. Christina Hearn has more.
Novak Djokovic declared last night's win here at Melbourne Park the biggest of his career because of everything he had to overcome. After the deportation scandal of last year, doubts over his hamstring injury this year, and his father being photographed with pro-Putin supporters just days ago, the Serbian star overcame it all, defeating world number four Stefano Tsitsipas in straight sets to claim his 10th Australian Open title. He broke down and sobbed when he climbed into the stands to hug his team, letting the emotion of the past year out for all to see. Djokovic now equals Rafael Nadal's record of 22 Grand Slam titles, and in a show of confidence, had a jacket ready to go with the number 22 on it for the trophy presentation.
This has been one of the most challenging tournaments I've ever played in my life. I want to thank all the people that made me feel welcome, made me feel comfortable. This probably is the, I would say, biggest victory in my life, considering the circumstances.
I would like to, I admire what you have done for our sport. I think you make me a better player when I'm out on court, so thank you.
There were extraordinary scenes outside Rod Laver Arena with hundreds of Serbian fans gathering at Garden Square and partying well into the night. Celebrations have also begun in the Serbian capital of Belgrade, and those celebrations are set to continue with Novak Djokovic now on the cusp of becoming the greatest player ever.
Former Australian cricketer Stuart McGill has come face to face with a woman who has accused him of stalking, intimidating and verbally attacking her in Sydney. Samantha Ford has told a court she felt scared and threatened when the former spin bowler allegedly abused her in February last year. She described McGill as being highly intoxicated and having wild eyes at the time. The retired cricketer is defending those charges. A man and a woman will face court today over an alleged kidnapping and murder on the New South Wales Central Coast. The 30-year-old man and 33-year-old woman were arrested yesterday after a man's body was found inside their Wyong unit. It's alleged they held two people against their will for up to 3 days. A 44-year-old woman managed to escape but suffered serious injuries. A 52-year-old father of two has died after being hit by a car allegedly driven by his close friend of more than 20 years. Justin Wilman was struck in a paddock at Stonehaven, west of Geelong. A 42-year-old man will face court today, charged with dangerous driving causing death. The family of the driver says they believe the death was an accident. Israel's Prime Minister will make it easier for people to get gun licenses and strengthen Jewish settlements on the West Bank in the wake of a terror attack which killed seven people at a synagogue in Jerusalem. Nine's Europe correspondent Kariane Greenbank has more.
Well, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's new right-wing government says it is planning to strengthen illegal Israeli settlements in the West Bank, and it's also planning to fast-track gun permits, which would allow thousands of extra Israeli citizens to carry weapons. The past month has seen a wave of deadly violence in Israel and the West Bank, culminating a few days ago in the deadliest attack on Israelis in 15 years. Seven people gunned down outside a synagogue in East Jerusalem, killed by a Palestinian gunman. Now, this is the scenario that US Secretary of State Antony Blinken will be walking into when he arrives in Israel very soon for a two-day visit. The visit was pre-planned, but with this new violence and growing tension, it takes on a new level of urgency.
The lawyer for the family of Tyre Nichols has made a desperate plea for US Congress to pass policing reform after the 29-year-old was allegedly beaten to death by five officers during a routine traffic stop in Memphis.
They can do something, Dana Bash. They got to try. We haven't had federal police reform since President Lyndon Baines Johnson, Great Society. It didn't happen with Rodney King. It didn't happen with Michael Brown and Ferguson.
Protests have erupted across the country after shocking body cam footage of the incident was made public. Australian musicians and writers have been promised a leg up as part of a $300 million plan to breathe life back into the arts industry. Live 2 Federal Politics reporter Fiona Willenfee, good morning. The Prime Minister is unveiling the new policy this morning.
Sophie, Anthony Albanese is at a live music venue in Melbourne making this announcement. So it's a plan worth $286 million. And at the centre of it is a new body called Creative Australia. That'll include a number of other agencies which will look after Australian music and literature, as well as First Nations artists. Now, on the music side of things, there'll be new measures to give Australian artists a greater chance at getting exposure on the world stage. It'll aim to improve the export market and also get songwriting and recording into schools. Now, the goal is to revive the arts industry, which was severely affected by the pandemic. And today the Prime Minister acknowledged that as he unveiled this policy.
You have endured a decade in which opportunity wasn't so much missed as thrown away, capped by the years of the pandemic, in which the loss of opportunity was exacerbated by what was a calculated neglect.
Now, the government has also announced new rules for streaming giants such as Netflix, Disney and Amazon. So it wants to force them to invest some of their revenue back into making Australian content. Look, the details are yet to be confirmed, but the industry has been pushing for a 20% quota. The aim is for the change to come into effect by July next year.
Okay, Fee, thank you. Well, one of the country's biggest unions will push for significant wage increases this year as workers face a horror show on housing. The CFMEU, which represents thousands of construction workers, is calling for employers to limit the use of labour hire and engage more apprentices. Nicholas Tedros, who was critically injured in the SeaWorld helicopter crash, has made a miraculous recovery, according to his family's priest. The 10-year-old has been cleared of serious brain injury and is reportedly speaking to those closest to him. He now faces a long wait to see if his right leg can be saved.